New Hampshire has about 1,000 lakes and ponds and thousands of miles of rivers and streams, but global warming is starting to threaten some, and that could mean big changes in how we interact with our freshwater resources. So many Granite Staters enjoy swimming, fishing, and boating on lakes, ponds, and rivers. But as the climate warms, scientists are seeing some negative impacts on New Hampshire's freshwater ecosystem.
We are seeing an increase in cyanobacteria blooms in New Hampshire, and it is likely a cause of nutrients and temperatures.
Amanda McQuaid, a specialist in ecotoxicology, says that bacteria is becoming more prevalent in our lakes and ponds and will continue.
We might expect an increase in the cyanobacteria in New Hampshire if we do see some significant increases in warming temperatures.
Along with the rise in temperature, we're also seeing more storms with higher amounts of precipitation. The average annual rainfall in Concord in the past 30 years is higher than any previous 30-year span, going all the way back to 1901. As the president of New Hampshire Lakes, Andrea Lamoureux, suggests, this higher number is playing a role in increasing the amount of bacteria in New Hampshire lakes.
When we have these bigger storms, we have more water running off the landscape and washing off pollution and washing off soil. And that pollution in soil gets into our lakes and basically helps that bacteria grow it.
There are some small steps that every New Hampshire property owner can take to help against added soil and pollution entering our lakes, like Babusick Lake and Amherst.
You know, doing simple things at your property, like, you know, having lots of vegetation to soak up that rainwater and to keep the soil in place. Those are simple things that everyone can do to help minimize that polluted runoff water.
Invasive plants like milfoil are also becoming more common, as warmer water provides a good environment for growth.
As our climate warms, becomes more, you know, similar to the southern part of the country, we'll have some of those plants and animals start to survive here in our lakes, causing all sorts of ecological issues.
Speaking of animals, as water temperatures climb, New Hampshire's freshwater fish also face difficulties. As John McGee, fish habitat biologist at New Hampshire Fish and Game, forecasts, streams and lakes may become unsuitable for cold water fish.
We're particularly interested in wild brook trout. Essentially, in some places, they're going to go away. The water is going to get too warm for them, and those populations are simply going to die out. At a minimum, the populations will be reduced.
According to a lot of model predictions, we can expect drier summers and longer periods without rainstorms. Recent dry stretches are already having an impact.
We have done a lot of work where we've been out doing our standard fish surveys, and we go back to a stream a couple of years later and it's completely dry. The years just before that, there was just a very strong, you know, seemingly healthy wild brook trout population.
But not all is lost. New Hampshire Lake says you can do small things like adding native plants to your backyard. And if everyone makes small changes, it will make a meaningful impact.